Good afternoon. I'm Commander Subhash Dutta, retired from the Navy, served for 24 years plus, and I've been working with the cybersecurity companies ever since I left Navy in 2008. Presently, I am Vice President, and I am also looking after R&D and malware research at a company called Sequretek IT Solutions Private Limited. This is a company based out of Bombay. I am based out of Gurgaon at one of our offices. We have office in Bangalore as well as in New Jersey, USA. We primarily deal with cybersecurity, and we have a cybersecurity consulting organization, and we also have our cybersecurity product development division. My role is in between both these verticals of our organization, so I provide inputs and I provide guidance and I provide intelligence to product development. Cybersecurity for the ships is very important for two aspects. The main aspect is that there is, due to the large automation of all the processes of a ship, be it a merchant ship or a naval ship, the processes are more or less different. In the case of naval ships, there are slightly enhanced processes or an enhanced degree of automation required. There is a large component of IT which now integrates with the operational technology of the ships. Because of the larger need for automation and the larger and the most diverse systems available on these ships, the IT has also kept up pace, and it takes advantage of better computing power, more resources, cheaper resources. So therefore, this integration between the IT world and the OT world has increased substantially on the ships. The major operational technology systems on a ship would be comprising bridge management system, which would include navigation, it would include communication systems. It would also include operational systems like the maritime distress systems, automatic identification systems. Other systems operationally which are used and which are also automated include systems related to power generation and propulsion, systems related to cargo management, systems related to crew handling, systems related to passenger handling on passenger ships specifically. As regards naval ships, the operational systems are even more diverse and more complicated. These systems include systems related to sensor fusion to begin with, so as to provide a common tactical operation picture. These systems also include fire control systems. Majority of the weapon systems are now controlled by IT run systems, and so therefore the fire control systems therefore are software and hardware driven. Communication systems, again very sophisticated encrypted communication systems, be it an RF communication or a satellite based communication systems on naval ships, that again is a very complicated system. So therefore, what has happened is, in the recent past, is that there is a greater degree of integration between these two technologies, that is the operational technology and the information technology. The threats which the information technology of a business organization or a business entity other than the maritime domain, and in the maritime domain there are hardly any differences. The threats which are impinging upon the information technology in the business environment outside a maritime domain will include the chances of data loss. It would include the data manipulation. It would also include large amount of disruption of their activities. The same kind of activities are also possible on IT systems on board ships and in maritime organizations, which are the back-end support of these ships. So therefore, if we take into account the processes by which these attacks take place, the starting point is a vulnerability in a system. These vulnerabilities can creep in systems because of the configuration, because of the old age of the systems, or because of the integration that these systems have with each other and the trust relationships that they have with each other. They could be exploited. So any of these vulnerabilities then is exploited by attackers. The roots are, the exploitation could occur in two ways. It could be a deliberate malicious activity by the attackers, or it could be an inadvertent consequence of totally benign actions. a user who probably doesn't know that these are the security things in place. They are there to provide him a safe and a productive environment. Instead of that, the user tries to disable certain security controls. So therefore, bringing in vulnerabilities in the systems. Most of these systems and most of these attackers now focus on social engineering aspects to carry out their attacks rather than attacking the systems per se. Social engineering is targeted towards human beings, towards the users specifically. So therefore, the attackers have now leveraged their attack processes to attack the users rather than attacking the systems, which are become more complicated and more robust than ever. So if I as an attacker can entice a user to provide me access to the internal systems without carrying out any malicious activity, I would rather go into that route rather than carrying out a physical attack or a cyber attack on one of the security systems. So phishing, which is the primary reason or a primary vector for infection in this organization, is the most preferred route for the attackers. Now, based on this, what could happen? What are the consequences of a cyber attack on the ships? The first and the most immediate consequence is your access to the sensitive data is now available to an attacker. What could thereafter happen is that that data itself is compromised. It could be extracted and monetized by the attackers. It could be sold or other, you know, activities associated with that data could be carried out. If it is a payment card related data on passenger ship, that could again be used to create duplicate credit cards, and purchases could be made on those based on that information. The other aspect is of manipulation of that particular data or corruption of that data. So if there are a large number of information touch points or large number of systems which are there, which are handling this kind of data, if they are brought down, it has a direct impact on the operations of that particular organization. The other impact of the cyber attacks on these ships could be in on the the operational technology of the ships. So critical operation systems like power generation, the propulsion systems, the bridge management systems, or the navigation systems and the communication systems, if they could be affected, the effects could be, you know, devastating on the complete viability of that ship. If it is a passenger ship, there is also a danger to the loss of life of the passengers and the crew themselves. So therefore, there are magnified effects of these kind of attacks on the operational technology of a ship. Spoofing of the navigational systems like the GPS and disruption of automatic identification system, which is a mandatory requirement for all ships, is one of the biggest culprits or biggest problems that these ships face on attacks on their operational systems. So how do we thwart these attacks? How do we stop these attacks from happening? One of the first things to do is to have visibility and identification of your users, your data, and your systems. Who all are the users within your environment? To what degree are they authorized to handle the data within your environment? If you have that visibility, then you can go a step further as to where is that data residing? And therefore, what all are the systems which are processing that data or storing that data? What are the security controls around these three pillars of the protection systems? The next step comes in having to develop a detective capability. That means you should be able to detect the abnormal activities within your environment vis-a-vis the normal activities. The only way to do that is to have constant monitoring of your systems and constant monitoring of your data, the data flow itself, and also to integrate a threat intelligence feed into your environment. If you do not have visibility to what the attackers are doing outside, the threat intelligence feed provides you with those indicators of compromise, and therefore it provides you a contextual correlation between what is happening within your environment and what is happening outside in the world. Once you have these ability to have visibility over your entire infrastructure and your users, then you can put into place protective measures. It starts off with putting a security framework in place. There are open standards, there are regulations, there are regulatory requirements. one of the most common standards which are used by all organizations which are using IT as their business operations, for their business operations, is ISO 27001, which is an information security management system. It's an internationally recognized standard, and it mandates certain security requirements to be put into place to manage the information security within an organization. For the shipping industry specifically, there are large number of guidelines, there are large number of regulations published by IMO, they are published by European Union, these are published by a consortium of BIMCO and other shipping organizations on specific technical recommendations to protect your information systems. And there are regulatory requirements that some of these recommendations should form part of your ship management system and the ship's protection systems. Once you have these frameworks in place, then you can put in security controls. Then all the technological pieces of the security then come into play. Access controls, segregation of networks, role-based access to users, and therefore having visibility and control over the activities of the users on that particular data. Response and recovery is a very important aspect of the cyber risk management process. So therefore, you must develop resilient systems, because these attacks will continue. There is no denying that, you know, tomorrow these attacks will cease, because these attacks are gaining prominence and they are becoming much better at what they do. So therefore, building resilient systems, building recovery into the systems, and being able to have recovery of your data and to carry on with your operations in the face of the attacks, these are some of the most critical components of a cyber risk management system. Thank you.